In this video, I would like to demonstrate four ways that you can set up your displays using AMD's Catalyst Control Center. Those four ways are to rotate a display, duplicate a display from another display, how to extend a desktop from another display, and then finally how to arrange multiple extended desktops to ensure that your mouse will move through the displays that you have arranged based on how they're physically set up. Creating an affinity group is another way that you can set up your displays, but I'm going to cover that in a future video. The first thing that I would like to cover is how to rotate a display into a portrait orientation. Now, many users find that a display in a portrait orientation will make reading online newspapers or working with long documents much easier because more information can be seen on the display before they would need to scroll down. Now, to rotate a display, we just bring up our Catalyst Control Center by right-clicking on the desktop and choosing the option there to open it. I'm going to be using Basic View because I find Basic View is laid out in a very user-friendly manner, and a lot of the options and things you can do within Basic View are just laid out so that it just guides you through how to do them. To switch to Advanced View, you would just click on Preferences and choose Advanced View. Advanced View does give you all the same functionality as Basic View, but with additional features. But in this case, for what we're doing, I'm going to stick with Basic View because it's all covered within there. So in Basic View, Desktops and Displays, I'm going to choose Desktop Management. And from there, under Rotate Desktop, I'm going to click on the option to Rotate Desktop. You'll see what I'm referring to when I say things are nicely laid out. Here it shows you the current rotation you have, and then it gives you three choices with little pictures to demonstrate of the choices for rotation that are available to you. Portrait, Landscape Flipped, and Portrait Flipped are my choices. I know that my particular monitor physically rotates in a portrait flipped, so in that case I'm going to check portrait flipped and then I'm going to hit apply. When you hit apply, you get a dialog box asking if you wish to keep your changes or not. In this case, I'm going to hit yes and my changes will be kept. The next thing that I like to demonstrate within AMD's Catalyst Control Center is how to duplicate a display. Now, when you duplicate a display, you really are doing just that, in that you're duplicating the information from one display and putting it on another display, so they'll show the same thing. Now, you may see this in use in a presentation environment, for example, where you'd have an individual, let's say, on a laptop in the room, and they're duplicating that laptop to a larger display so that everyone can see what they're presenting. There are two big rules that I want you to be aware of before we show you how to duplicate a display. The first is that duplicated displays must be connected to the same video card. And secondly, duplicated displays must run the same resolution and refresh rate. Okay, now in the Catalyst Control Center, to duplicate a display, from the Start menu, just click on Add and Remove Displays, and then click on Duplicate Display. If you have just one other display connected, it'll automatically duplicate the display to it because there's no other ones to choose from. If you have more than just one other display connected, you'll be presented with the choice of what display you want to duplicate to, and then you would click Apply. Again, you'll be presented with the confirmation box of to keep these changes, yes or no. You would click yes, and your changes will be kept. Now, I'd like to demonstrate how to extend a desktop. When you extend a display, you really give yourself the ability to have different applications open on each extended display. This allows you to have, for example, an email client open on one display while you work on an internet browser or a Word document on another display. And this is most common in an office environment because it enables individuals to increase their productivity and to multitask on different things. There are two things that we need to be aware of when we extend a display. The first is that you can have your displays that you're extending connected to different video cards. And secondly, the resolution and refresh rate can be different for each display that you're connecting. Now, to actually extend a display within AMD's Catalyst Control Center, from the Start menu, just click on Add Remove Displays, and then from there choose Extended Desktop. Now again, if you have just one display connected, it'll automatically extend to that display connected. If you have more than just one other display connected, you'll be presented with the choice of what display you'd like to extend to, and then you would click Apply. And again, the option dialog box of to save these changes, yes or no, will appear. You will click yes, and your changes will be kept. The last thing that I want to cover within AMD's Catalyst Control Center is how to arrange your extended desktops. Now, you may have found that your mouse doesn't move through your displays the way you'd like based on physically how you have them set up. Arranging desktops will correct that. In AMD's Catalyst Control Center, in the basic view, simply click on Start, and then under Desktops and Displays, click on Desktop Management. From there, choose Arrange Desktops. Now what you'll see is blue boxes that represent each display that you have extended. So a blue box for 1, 2, 3, 4, for however many you have. And there'll be a button to identify all. What I recommend you do is actually just draw on a piece of paper a diagram that represents your physical monitor setup, and then as you hit Identify All, a big number 1, 2, 3, 4, etc. will appear in each display. Write down those numbers into the corresponding monitor on your drawn diagram. Once the diagram is complete, all you need to do is drag and drop the blue boxes in the software to mimic the diagram that you've drawn. Click Apply, and that'll keep the new arrangement. Now, you should see that your mouse will move through the displays as you like, based on how they're physically set up. Thank you for watching this video on how to use AMD's Catalyst Control Center to rotate, duplicate, extend, and finally arrange extended desktops. I know we've covered quite a bit, but I hope you found it helpful. Feel free to watch any component of the video over again, and don't forget to leave your comments below. To create the Infinity Group, we're going to use AMD's Vision Engine Control Center. It's also known as the Catalyst Control Center.